गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम मनप्रीत सिंह फ्रॉम इंग्लिश गेट ओवरसीज। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब व्हाट इज देयर इन द राइटिंग मॉड्यूल ऑफ एकेडमिक आइल्स। सो इन दिस वीडियो पर्टिकुलरली वी आर गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन द टास्क वन। सो व्हाट इज देयर इन टास्क वन? एज वी ऑल नो दैट देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ टास्क विच आर आस्क्ड बाय द IELTS examiners, task 1 and task 2. So this is the task 1 of the writing module of academic IELTS. Okay, so I will write here academic IELTS because as we all know that there are two types of IELTS, IELTS academic as well as IELTS general. So candidates who are aspiring to go abroad for study purpose, they are required to do academic IELTS, and the band score may differ from organization to organization. Okay, so today we are going to talk about task 1. So what we have to do in the task 1? In the task 1, simply we have to write a report, and the word limit for this report should be not less than 150. But there is no upper limit. So if you will write less than 150, then it may deduct your score. But if you write more than 150, then you are fine, because that will not be an underlength report for which we normally we get a few less score. So 150 plus words. And if you talk about the time, then you are given 20 minutes total duration for the task 1. However, it entirely depends upon you whether you want to give it 25 minutes, half an hour. Okay, but ideal time for this task is 20 minutes, because this task is contributes to 3 band of your overall 9 bands. Okay, out of total 9 bands, this task gives you 3 bands. So I think if we have 1 hour for the writing, the whole writing module, then we should not spend more than 20 minutes in any circumstance, because it is only worth 3 bands. Okay, so next step is, you may be curious about knowing the type of questions. Like we know that we have to write a report, and we know that it is going to be 150 plus, and it's going to give us 3 bands out of 9 bands, and the time is 20 minutes. Then what type of questions are asked? So basically you have to write a report on these types. You know, you may get such line graph, where I think we have done line graphs in our previous studies also, in school time also, maybe we have seen them, but we rarely got an opportunity to write any report. But we know like what a line graph looks like. So a line graph look like exactly the same. There may be a single graph, or there may be a combination of many graphs also. So as we all know that there are two axes. So on the one axis there will be a time, categories, and on the other type there may be a data. Okay, the number like 1 million, 2 million, 3 million, 4 million, and here they can get a time from 1990 to 2010. So this is called a line graph. And the second type is bar graph. So bar graphs are slightly different from line graphs, but they are also showing the same things: time on the x-axis, and so like from 1990 to 2010 for example, and data on the y-axis, like 4 million, 6 million, 7 million. For example, it is about Coca-Cola sales. It may be about Coca-Cola sales, and they may tell you that Coca-Cola sales in Australia or India, and there will be a time on the x-axis, there will be a sale amount like 2 million, 4 million, 6 million on the y-axis. So now we will move to the next question type. Okay, so the next question type is pie chart. So we all know about the pies which we normally eat. So this is exactly looking like a pie chart, you know, and the pie chart is divided into different slices, different areas. For example, in the task one of the academic IELTS, you may get a pie chart also, and you will have to write a report on a pie chart. So what this pie chart is showing is water consumption, how much water was consumed in India, and it is divided into three categories. Like 50% area shows that 50% water was used by the houses in India, and this part here, this part, 25% nearly, shows the water was used by farmers, and remaining 25% area shows that this water was utilized for the factories. So all this information you will have to describe in a report, and we will look more into detail how to deal with this type of questions in our forthcoming videos. So the next type, so this one was the third type, and this one is the fourth type. So the fourth type is a table. So it is a table, and it is showing from 1990 to 1994. So this is the time. Okay, and it is showing the salaries. Okay, salary in millions. Okay, for example, this is just an example. The data may be different, the information may be different, different tables may have different type of information. So this is just for an example, because somebody may say that no, this type of tables we have never faced in our exams. This is just an example, just to give you an overview what type of questions you may get in task one. So here's the table, so here's the data, and here's the salary of A, B or C, or maybe the salary of the people from A country, B country or C country in millions. Okay, now we will move to the next question type. All right, so the fifth type is map. So in the final exam we may get a map. Okay, for example, this is a map of New York City. Okay, we may get a different type of questions in this particular category. Like here there is a map of New York in 2010, means what was there in New York in 2010 in past. Okay, and what is there in the same city now in 2020, means present. So you will get a couple of maps, like between past, what was there in past, what is there in the present, or maybe you can get something different, like what is there in present in 2020, and what will be there, what changes will be there in future. So you may get a different type of questions in this very particular category, present and past, or present and future, or you may only get present, like New York looks like this, you have to describe. Okay, and more detail we can talk about a particular video about the map. So you can get a question like map. And sixth type, you can get a question related to a diagram, where you may get a process or a flow chart. Okay, so here this process is showing brick manufacturing. So how the bricks are made, so this is a process, like the stage A, what happens at stage A, what happens at the starting age, and what happens next at stage B, as this arrow is referring to stage B. Then what happens at a stage C, what happens at the final stage. Okay, for example, delivery, final stage is delivery of bricks. First stage can be digging of clay, okay, heating. Second stage can be heating. Third stage can be cooling. So this is how the bricks are made. So this is a process. You will get a process chart. You will have to explain each and every stage. You will have to write a report. What the first stage includes, what happens next, what happens following this, what happens at the last stage. Okay, so it may be a diagram, it may be a process chart, it may be a flow chart, depending on different issue, maybe brick manufacturing, maybe milk production. So topic may be different. This is just an example. As I told you in the beginning of the video, that these are just examples. We will look more into detail how to solve them, each and every thing, step by step. Okay, and the very final type I would like to talk about. So now we know that in the task one we have to write a report, and it should be not less than 150 words. The ideal time is 20 minutes because it is only worth 3 bands out of total 9 bands, so nearly 25% of your total score. And type of questions, as we have already discussed, like you may get a bar graph, you may get a pie chart, you may get a table, you may get a map, you may get a process chart, you know, or you may get a line graph, the very first which we discussed. And last is a combination of both. You may get a combination of both also. You may get them individually also, like you can only get a table, you can only get a map, pie chart, you can only get a bar, you can only get, but you may get a combination also. For example, you may get in one question, you may get a line graph and you may get a bar graph as well. They may be related to different issues, but you will have to summarize them into one report. So you can get them on single basis also, and you can get the combination of both also. It combination can be different, like maybe you get a bar graph plus you get a pie chart, or maybe you get a bar graph or a table. So you may get a combination also. So don't be surprised if you see in your final exam and you think that it is going to be only one task, you know, it may be a combination of both also. Okay, so this was all about the overview of the task one. And if you have any queries relating your task one of the academic IELTS, for example, maybe you are already preparing somewhere for the IELTS academic exam, or maybe you have already appeared in a couple of exams, or you are failed, you are not able to get your desired score. So you can meet me, you can contact me, and you can attend the demo classes at English Gate Overseas in Pundri in District Kaithal. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please share this video as much as you can. And if someone is missing on this video, you can replay this video and you can see what we have already discussed. And I will see you in the next video with more details about the upcoming tasks. Thank you very much for watching this video.